dress me as a strong, independent Black woman, it's not a compliment. I never hear a man that is raising children alone say, I'm mom and dad. He never becomes overly feminine because he's raising children. But we as women become overly masculine because we are raising children, because I'm mom and dad and I gotta do all those things, right? And now I put extra stuff on me and then I say, ain't nobody helping me. Well, nobody told you to do that. There is help available, all because I was trying to overcompensate for what daddy wasn't doing. I didn't have to be mom and dad. Now they got Mr. Chris and Mr. Eric over here. And I took them to be a part of different organizations, because when you think of something strong, you do not think of coming to the aid of it. So when we are looked at and walk around as strong, what we're putting out is, I do not need assistance. I don't need your help. So anytime a man says, oh, I love that you're so strong, I said, no, I'm not strong. I'm resilient. I'm not independent. I'm interdependent. Because nobody ever comes to the aid of the strong person. So when I'm around men, my wrists are broke.
Okay, so this is our first topic. This is where we really want it to be. I mean, the entire time we want it to be interactive, right? Because we're trying to learn different things, and this is one of those situations. So please, if you have any comments, questions, what your thoughts are on this topic in particular, then please put that in the chat. I'm going to go first, though, to Sheri for her opinion on it. So what do you think about this? What stood out to me in this particular video, my favorite line, when you think of something strong, you do not think of coming to the aid of it. I thought that was really powerful. So she said, though, that she didn't like being called an independent woman. Sheri, what do you think about that? Do you think that's an insult?
I think it's an insult, but I think it's individualized. Everyone's going to be different. Everyone's going to see it different. Everyone is going to take it different. I was taught, I mean, it's a cultural thing too. I was taught to be independent. My mom raised 8 kids on her own after my father passed, and she has 6 girls. So she wanted her girls to be independent and not dependent on someone to take care of them if it comes to that, because, you know, things changed for her when my father died, right? So she had to pick it up and move on. And she taught us to be independent and to be as strong as we can. And that's all I know, right? Can I ask for assistance? Yeah. Is it hard sometimes? Yeah, because I want to be able to do it. But that's the way I was raised. And it's how each household is raised. And that's how you become that individual. So I would say I'm 50-50 on that, because I was taught that way and by a mother who was a strong woman and her before her. So it's a learned thing for me, and I wear it as an armor.
Yeah, I kind of agree with you, Sheri, as well. But I think too is that it's funny, because I looked up the definition of an independent woman, and I got the urban definition. It says it's a woman who pays her own bills, buys her own clothes, and does not allow a man to affect her stability or confidence. And then there's another definition that says that an independent woman is determined, she's firm, iron-willed, resolute, strong-willed, unbending, and uncompromising. So no wonder that lady was offended, right? If you're looking at those definitions, for me, being an independent woman, I kind of wear that with a badge of honor. I think when you put that black, you know, that black woman independence, there's an issue with that, because I think as society right now, I think it has an issue with black women in general, but that's, you know, that's another subject for another day. But I also think that there's a little bit of that feminist that's in there as well, is that, you know, during the feminist time, you know, to be a woman, you know, to be a strong woman or independent woman, you had to burn your bra and you were doing all these other things. So I think for me, the big misconception is that, you know, there's nothing wrong with being a strong woman. You know, I wear it with a badge of honor. And then on the same note, I don't have a problem asking for help personally. You know, I think what Sheri said, it's all in how you're raised, you know, and I don't have a problem having my wrist broken at some time. You know, I mean, I don't like taking out the trash. I'm independent, but if I was living alone, I would have to take out the trash. I have somebody here that does that for me. So for me, I like my independence, and I kind of understand the reason why she got mad. But for me, again, like I said, it's just, it's okay for me to be independent.
I totally agree with the young woman in the video. I, like Sheri, I come from the same type of household. And every year for Father's Day, my mother used to actually get offended when people would wish her happy Father's Day because she didn't want to feel like, you know, masculine. You know, at the same time, she had to, you know, handle her responsibilities, but she did it with such grace. And that's something that I've always admired. But with that being my upbringing, you know, I do have such a deep respect for that. But at the same time, I wouldn't want to be super independent my whole life. You know, like, I am looking for that interdependence. So, like, definitely, like Gail, like, I am looking to do that. But at the same time, I don't want to be, I don't want to rely upon that. Like, you know, I'm solid by myself. And if you can add to the garden, then great. So those are just my sentiments on that.
Okay, so I was trying to get some chat in the chat. I was trying to get thoughts. So ladies, when you were talking, a lot of you were talking about like cultural references. Do you think that, and Gail specifically, you mentioned that within like for Black women especially, and I couldn't remember how it was that you placed it or how it was that you put it, but do you feel like there is some sort of a stigma or something associated with Black women in particular and how we relate to having independence?
I think so. I think, you know, and I'm not sure what the connection is, but, you know, I mean, I just think that Black women in general, you know, of late, we kind of get a bad rap, you know, for me. But I just think that, I think because we have always been in the background per se, you know, and now that you are starting to see, you know, African-American women, you know, CEOs, we have a vice president that's an African-American. So I think what happens is that, you know, people look at it and say, oh, well, what did she do to get there? You know, oh, she's mean, she's nasty, you know? So I think for us, I think it's always been there. And I'm not saying it happened in other races, but I think now the fact that we are becoming a little bit more outspoken and we're running our own businesses, we're doing those things. I think the spotlight has just been more on us of late.
I think that, so as we kind of talked about before, when I brought up this video, I said, I run into this a lot, me personally. And it's like, oh, you know, you work out and you do all these different things. And that's why I also wanted not only from a woman's perspective, but also from a man's perspective as to how they feel about this video, because I'm always having to sort of explain away, yeah, I'm independent, but that doesn't mean I want to do everything. You know, that means I can, you know, but at some point I want to be able to have this relationship, as Cyna said, you know, this interdependent relationship with someone where we're partners and where we do things together, you know, because that's what you do. You meet someone and you're wanting to bring the two of you together to make a more dynamic team. And then to be able to, I don't want to use that word because then that's going to, I think, trigger some people. So I won't use the word that automatically came to mind. And I can't think of something else. But you want to be able to trust your partner and or this person that you're with, you know, to partner up and to be a unit and to be a team. And so I have, though, in my past had situations to where my independence was, at first it was like, oh yeah, you're so independent, so like you can do it. No, and I'm like, if I could do everything, or if I wanted to do everything on my own, then I wouldn't need someone else. I wouldn't need to be with someone else, right? But then you have people on the other side of that who are like, no, I'm independent, I can do everything all by myself, you know. It's like, I'm not that person. So I try to make that clear. But anyone else? So I'm trying to read some of the comments. So someone was saying that they agree with you all. I think independence is a good thing. As far back as I can remember, independence has been the goal from childhood. And then we have someone that said there's a balance with it. Independence is a good thing. Who doesn't want to be self-sufficient? But I think there's a time when you should accept support and be unafraid to ask for it. And we've had this discussion before about being afraid to ask and what help and what that looks like. And why do you think that, and we discussed it a little bit previously, but why do you think that we have such a hard time with asking for help as women?
It goes right back to your cultural upbringing, right? Yeah. And it just trickles down from generation to generation of that independence of not asking for help, because if you can't do it yourself or you can't get it within your family, like don't take it outside the family, right? We can deal with it as it is. So it's always a taboo to go outside the fence and ask for help. Now it's becoming, you know, better in some sense, but I feel like some of the older generation is just like, no. And I don't think it's just a cultural difference for the Black community. I think it's in other communities as well, of it being hush hush. Certain things are not said, things are not done. And that's, and one of the things are asking for assistance outside of that family area or that demographic, right? They don't want outsiders. So it all depends. It's cultural. I think it's cultural for most of them.
I think too is that, you know, a lot of people feel it's a sign of weakness, you know, a sign of, you know, I can't take care of myself, you know, I can do it better. I don't want to ask anybody, because if I want it done right, I'm going to do it myself, you know, trying to be everything and everything and all things, you know, to just taking care of it, you know, and kind of like what you were saying, Sheri, I think we talked about this at another time, was that, you know, in the African American community, a lot of times, you know, there were just a lot of single mothers, you know, our men being incarcerated or, you know, or having to work, you know, two or three jobs, and the mother, you know, she's a stay at home mom or whatever. So I think, you know, a lot of times you just make do. You know, I remember my mom, you know, you just make do with what you have, you know, and you only have, like Sheri said, your family, you know, and then on the other side of the coin, like I said, it could be a sign of weakness. For me, I don't have a problem asking for help, but it depends on too what I'm asking for help for. You know, asking for help for money, that's a touchy subject. You know, you don't want people in your business. So it depends on, for me, I think it's based on what am I asking, and it probably shouldn't be like that, but that's how it is for me.
Yeah, I mean, pretty much it's like you are what you see. So I didn't really see a lot of that growing up. Like, my mom's super independent. So I personally do have a real big issue with asking for money. I won't take anything, you know, and I will literally just be humble, you know, but because I just don't like the idea of like being indebted to an individual. But at the same time, it's like I didn't see extreme monetary gifts from, you know, like, you know, really, really, really like close family, I guess, so to speak. So, yeah.
Okay. Well, we're going to wrap this up. Thank you guys for your...